Man, that's not gonna get it, man. Gotta come better than this. My head is killing me, man. Gazing at this blank page, channeling my deep cerebral phase. My mind slowly reaches the ninth stage. Boom, now I've captured it. The paragraphical map is scrambled in my inner cranial labyrinth. I'm focused, let's go after it. I move in carefully. The canvas stares at me with apathy. And as I struggle, it sarcastically talks back to me. Frustration pops in. The strain out a classical concoction is painstaking, but failure's not an option. A spark the size of a quark tries to take shape and develop into what becomes an embryonic thought. My endorphins release and start chasing it. My cerebellum embraces it, but my haste and over-anxiousness erases it. A split second away from delivering. Was at the edge of my mental, but quickly backflipped into the river of oblivion. I'm almost nauseous. Why should I be cautious when all this inanimate garbage is under my auspice? The vision within, the smooth black pen. But when a concept begins, something pushes it back in. All the inspiration ceases, a sharp pain increases. Scattered fragments of a thesis, but my mind won't release it. Fighting something not typical to fight with. Stare at the page all night till my sight quit. My occipital might split, so scandalous is the virgin canvas. With no regard for the man who tried to channel his deepest thoughts to romance it. The canvas, where great works of art rest. Where creative inspiration is made manifest. Philosophies and dreams executed by the hand before it's sent out to man. This is where it all began. The canvas, where great works of art rest. Where creative inspiration is made manifest. Philosophies and dreams executed by the hand before it's sent out to man. This is where it all began.
The canvas.
As vast as the Atlantic, where the righteous and the rancid ideas of man sit, the organic and the outlandish. The three-way connection between my thoughts page and the pen that I brandish. I wrote a line I felt from within. Yeah. The page regurgitated back in the form of a flame that melted my pen. I replaced it with one I figured was greater. The first acceptable line finally hits the paper several hours later. I was tired but couldn't rest till I'm through. The canvas spoke to me again and calmly asked, is that the best you could do? I said, fool, I got a message for you. How you gonna disrespect my work and all of this time I've invested in you? It said you full of intellectual wealth. You started this, so now you gotta live up to the standard you set for yourself. The unparalleled creations, the timeless innovations, the mixture of real life situations and useful information. I asked, why do you care? It replied, how can you lyrically stimulate people's minds if you and I don't coincide? Beside the fact I'm being protective of you, would you wanna have something written on your body that's not reflective of you? Had to agree that its perspective was true. So in a second or two, I brainstormed and intellectually grew. It was torture and my thoughts were exhausted. I didn't draw a mountainside or a wild orchid, but a literary portrait. And what I wrote, the page no longer denounced it. My mind pushed and gave birth to a verse that weighed 3 tons and 7 ounces. I asked, how do you like it? It said, I love it. Now I know my page will only accept words that are worthy of it.
Yeah. The canvas, where great works of art rest. Where creative inspiration is made manifest. Philosophies and dreams executed by the hand before it's sent out to man. This is where it all began. The canvas, where great works of art rest. Where creative inspiration is made manifest. Philosophies and dreams executed by the hand before it's sent out to man. This is where it all began.
Ooh, look at it. Beautiful, so beautiful. What shall we name it?